2018 is proving to be a very busy year for India's space agency ISRO, with a mission planned for each month. The Indian Space Research Organization has already launched three important satellites between January 1 and April 12. These include remote sensing satellite CARTASAT-2 on board the PSLV C-40 rocket in January, communications satellite GSAT-6A on board GSLV F-08 rocket on March 29, and navigation satellite IRNSS-1I on board the PSLV C-41 rocket on April 12. In the next 8 months, ISRO has 9 more important missions planned, ISRO Chairman K Sivan told reporters at the Sathish Dhawan Space Centre in Andhra Pradesh's Sriharikota last week. This means ISRO will average one mission every month for the year 2018, which would be a remarkable achievement. Chandrayaan-2 mission. Expected to be the biggest mission of all this year, Chandrayaan-2 will be India's second mission to the Moon. Unlike Chandrayaan-1, which only had a lunar orbiter, Chandrayaan-2 will have an orbiter, a lander and a rover. According to ISRO's plan, after reaching the 100 km lunar orbit, the lander housing the rover will separate from the orbiter. After a controlled descent, the lander will soft land on the Moon's surface at a specified site and deploy the rover. The rover, which will be six-wheeled, will move around the landing site in semi-autonomous mode as decided by the ground commands. The instruments on the rover will observe the lunar surface and send back data, which will be useful for analysis of the Moon's soil. The orbiter of Chandrayaan-2 will weigh around 3,290 kilograms and will orbit around the Moon to perform the objectives of remote sensing the Moon. The payloads will collect scientific information on lunar topography, mineralogy, elemental abundance, lunar exosphere and signatures of hydroxyl and water ice. The Chandrayaan-2 mission will be launched on board the GSLV F-10 rocket, and is planned for the second half of 2018, aimed for October. The GSAT-11 mission. As explained by ISRO, the GSAT-11 is a multi-beam high-throughput communication satellite operating in Ka and Ku bands employing a new bus. It provides 32 user beams in Ku band and 8 gateway beams in Ka band. The payload includes Ka-X Ku-band forward link transponders and Ku-X Ka-band return link transponders. The GSAT-11 satellite is planned to be launched by Ariane from Kourou, French Guiana in first half of 2018, aimed for June. India's GSAT satellites are indigenously developed communication satellites which are used for digital audio and video broadcasting. The GSAT satellites are geosynchronous satellites, having a geosynchronous orbit, which means they have an orbital period the same as the Earth's rotation period. The GSAT series of satellites have been developed by ISRO with an aim to make India 100% self-reliant in broadcasting services. C-band, extended C-band and Ku-bands provide services for telecommunications, television broadcasting, weather forecasting, disaster warning and search and rescue operations. The GSAT-11 will be the heaviest satellite ever made by ISRO. The weight of the satellite will be in excess of 5.7 tons, more than 5,100 kilograms. The GSLV MK3D2 GSAT-29 mission. GSAT-29, which too is a GSAT series satellite as explained above, is configured around ISRO's enhanced 1-3K bus and will be the payload for second developmental flight of GSLV MK3. It carries Ka-X Ku multi-beam and optical communication payloads for the first time. The mission targets for village resource centers, VRC, in rural areas to bridge the digital divide. The GSLV MK3D2 GSAT-29 mission is scheduled to be launched during the first half of 2018. The satellite will weigh around 3,500 kilograms. The GSLV MK3D2 will launch the GSAT-29. We are going to have a host of GSLV missions like DGSAT and high-resolution remote sensing satellites, ISRO Chairman K Sivan confirmed. GSAT-7A mission. The GSAT-7A satellite is an advanced military communications satellite. It will be dedicated for the sole use of the Indian Air Force. It is similar to the GSAT-7, which is currently being used exclusively by the Indian Navy. The Navy's GSAT-7 is a multi-band communication spacecraft, which has been operational since September 2013. The GSAT-7 satellite helps enable the Indian Navy to extend its blue water capabilities and stop relying on foreign satellites like Inmarsat, which provide communication services to its ships. Similarly, the GSAT-7A satellite will help the Indian Air Force spread its wings further. GSAT-7A will enable the Indian Air Force to interlink different ground radar stations, ground airbase and airborne early warning and control AWACS, aircraft. The GSAT-7A satellite will enhance the Indian Air Force's network-centric warfare capabilities and enhance its global operations. GSAT-7A is expected to be launched in the second half of 2018 and will be launched on board the GSLV MK2. The RISAT-1A mission. RISAT, or Radar Imaging Satellite, RISAT-1A, will be a remote sensing satellite that is similar in configuration to RISAT-1. It will be the third satellite in the RISAT series. RISAT-1, which was the second in the series, uses C-band 5.35 GHz synthetic aperture radar for Earth observation. Because of the 2008 Mumbai terror attacks, the RISAT-2 satellite took priority over the RISAT-1 satellite. RISAT-2 carried an Israeli-built X-band radar. This is how RISAT-2 became the first in the series and RISAT-1 became the second. The RISAT-1 satellite has a purpose of monitoring natural resources management, primarily agriculture planning and forestry surveys, as well as to predict and prevent flooding. It helps monitor paddy plantations and yields in the kharif season and to assists in food security planning. Pad abort test. ISRO is gearing up to conduct a critical crew bailout test to see how fast and effectively the crew module of an intended space mission could punch out from the spacecraft safely in the event of an emergency. The test, known as pad abort, will be held at the launch pad of Sriharikota high altitude range in a month or two. The test forms part of a gamut of critical technologies being developed by the space agency as it awaits the nod from the government for the ambitious Human in Space program. PSLV C-42 mission. The PSLV C-42 mission is planned in August, which may launch SSDLS-1, a dedicated commercial satellite. SSDLS-1 is an 1-meter high-resolution Earth observation satellite with high-speed downlink and 45 degrees off-pointing, which is built and owned by Surrey Satellite Technology Limited. CARTASAT-3 mission. CARTASAT-3 is an very high-resolution panchromatic, multispectral and hyperspectral Earth observation mission. CARTASAT-3 is designed as a follow-on to the CARTASAT-2 series. The satellite has an imaging payload with a ground resolution of 0.25 meters with 16 kilometers swath in panchromatic mode, a resolution of 1 meter with 16 kilometers swath in multispectral mode, and a resolution of 12 meters with 5 kilometers in hyperspectral mode. OceanSat-3 mission. The Indian Space Research Organization spacecraft OceanSat-3 and OceanSat-3A are envisaged to provide service continuity for the operational users of OCM, Ocean Color Monitor, data from OceanSat-2, as well as to enhance the application potential in other areas. It is a global mission and is configured to cover global oceans and provide continuity of ocean color data with global wind vector and characterization of lower atmosphere and ionosphere. The mission objectives are to provide continuity of ocean color data with improvements to continue and enhance operational services like potential fishery zone and primary productivity. To enhance the applications by way of simultaneous sea surface temperature, SST. Measurements. There may be RLVTD landing experiment. This time, the RLVTD will land on land instead of water. The RLVTD will almost be a ditto version of the first scaled-down RLVTD, with the only exception being it will have landing gear. The plan is to launch the RLVTD from Sriharikota and land it on an undisclosed Air Force airfield in the eastern sector. On whether the 2.2-ton GSAT-6A communication satellite which has lost contact with the ground station, Sumnath said it is continuously being tracked. GSAT-6A satellite is not on safe mode, if so then it will receive the command from ground station. The tracking is on as part of retrieval efforts to revive it, he said.